Hello friends, welcome to the series of organic chemistry lectures. Dear friends, today we are going to learn about polymerization. Right friends, let us take one example. N molecules of ethylene upon polymerization gives CH2, N molecules of polymer. This is known as polyethylene. What is polyethylene? Yes, polythene. Commonly we also call it as polythene. Yes, polythene bags. Alkene upon polymerization is going to give polyethylene. So it is a polymer. Monomer. So terminology, monomer. Poly, multiple, mono, one. So the one which is left hand side in the reaction is monomer, and the compound going to get after polymerization is known as polymer. So types, right friends, types of polymers. So the first one is addition polymers. That means whatever comes, the monomers will be added to each other, addition polymers. Or it is also known as chain elongation polymers. Right, addition polymers or chain elongation polymers. These are four types. So addition polymers are four types. One is free radical addition polymers. Right, second one is cationic addition polymers. Third one is anionic addition polymers. Yes friends, fourth one is coordination addition polymerization. This is very important. So here we are going to learn a reagent, Ziegler-Natta catalyst. Ziegler-Natta catalyst. This is very important catalyst. Ziegler-Natta catalyst. Right friends, what are the second type? So this is addition polymers, and the second type are condensation polymers. Condensation polymers. Dear friends, polymers are of two types, addition polymers and condensation polymers. Right, so under addition polymers we are going to learn about four types: free radical addition polymers, cationic addition polymers, anionic addition polymers, and coordination addition polymers. That is Ziegler-Natta catalyst, which is going to be mediated this type of polymerization reactions. And the second type is condensation polymers. So under this, the major, mainly water will be eliminated, or methanol or some other eliminated during the reaction. So condensation, so water will be eliminated, or methanol, right, or some other byproducts will be eliminated. So these are condensation polymers. Under this we are going to learn about nylon 66. Nylon 66 is a biodegradable polymer. Yes friends, so these are the polymers. Polymers, for example, ethylene monomer upon polymerization. So dibenzoyl peroxide and H nu polymerization takes place to give polyethylene. This is polymer. It is a free radical addition polymerization reaction example. Yes friends, so let us take one by one. Yes friends, under addition polymer reactions, yes, coordination addition polymerization. Main important aspect under this reaction is Ziegler-Natta catalyst. What is Ziegler-Natta catalyst? It is the combination of triethyl aluminium plus titanium tetrachloride. This is very important friends. Triethyl aluminium, titanium tetrachloride. Because of this invention, these two people got Nobel Prize in 1963. So triethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride are the reagents, are the catalysts, are going to be form coordination addition polymers. For example, vinyl chloride. What is vinyl chloride? CH2 double bond CH chloro, vinyl chloride. So upon polymerization, what is the reagent we are going to use? Triethyl aluminium. It is also written like this, titanium tetrachloride. Polymerization, what is going to give? Yes, CH2, CH, chloro, this is the polymer. So vinyl chloride, what is the polymer? Polyvinyl chloride. What is the short form of this? Polyvinyl chloride, PVC. PVC, what is this? Polyvinyl chloride. So PVC is commonly used as pipes, plastic pipes. So PVC, polyvinyl chloride, is prepared by coordination addition polymerization using Ziegler-Natta catalyst, right? Next, CF2, double bond CF2, tetrafluoroethylene. Upon polymerization, it is going to give fluoro, this is fluoro, this is, what is this? Poly tetrafluoroethylene, right? So what is the short name or commercial name of this? Teflon. Poly tetrafluoroethylene is a Teflon. It is highly stable compound. It is inactive towards most of the chemicals. So Teflon is very famous in organic chemistry because inactivity towards chemicals. So this Teflon is commonly used in organic chemical laboratory as Teflon tape, right? Teflon tape, you will get Teflon pipes also, right? Teflon reaction vessels also. So this is the Teflon, poly tetrafluoroethylene is Teflon, right friends? Next, for example, if I take CH2, CH, CH3, this is n moles of propene, what I am going to get? So under Ziegler-Natta catalyst, so I am going to get, so reaction conditions usually at low temperature around 10 degrees centigrade and the pressure will be 10 atmosphere, right? So under these reaction conditions, this reaction is going to be conducted, propene. So upon reaction or polymerization is going to give CH3, and this is the polymer of polypropylene. This is the polymer. Next, very important polymer is isoprene. What is isoprene? CH2, double bond CH3, CH, double bond CH2. This is isoprene. Isoprene is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Yes, isoprene. N moles of isoprene upon Ziegler-Natta catalyst under polymerization reaction conditions, it is going to give CH2, CH3, double bond CH and CH2, right friends? This is synthetic rubber. Isoprene gives synthetic rubber. So rubber, it is similar to natural rubber. So this synthetic rubber is prepared by Ziegler-Natta catalyst. Its another name is gutta percha. So it is similar to natural rubber. So it is prepared from isoprene. Yes friends, so this is the coordination addition polymerization. So what is the mechanism of this polymerization? Yes, what are the reagents we are going to use? Alkyl triethyl aluminium plus titanium tetrachloride is a transition metal. Titanium is a transition metal. It is expected, it is not clear, but however it is expected. It is neither goes through free radical nor cationic or anionic. So this is not yet decided. That is why it is going to undergo through coordination, addition, polymerization. This reagent is expected to form titanium trichloride plus diethyl aluminum plus ethyl free radical. So this ethyl and titanium is going to form a active catalyst is titanium, and it is going to have CH2CH3. This is active catalyst. It is expected, not proved, active catalyst complex. Yes friends, so this active catalyst, for example, if we take ethylene polyethylene, we are going to get ethylene, right? N moles of ethylene under this polymerization reaction conditions, we are going to get CH2 N moles of this polymer, right? Polymer, this is monomer ethylene. So this active catalyst, let us see the mechanism. So this active catalyst is going to come here, and coordination, it is going to form. So it is expected to form a coordination compound, titanium. So this, shall I write like this? CH2. So there will be chlorines. So CH2 will be there, CH2 CH3. So this is going to have this bond, coordination complex. So this coordination complex is going to, yes, rearrange to give titanium similar to this complex. So this CH2 CH2, this CH2 and CH3, right friends? It is similar to this active catalyst complex, and it, this type of coordination will goes on, takes place, right, till the end of the completion of this monomer in the reaction mixture to give polymer of this polymer. Yes friends, it is very simple. It goes on, extends to give this polymer. And the first stage, free radical polymerization, we have prepared same polymer, that is polyethylene, but the polymer which is prepared through this method are highly stable and rubber in nature, right? So that is why the polymers which are prepared by Ziegler-Natta catalyst are highly durable. So all the polymers, just now we have studied Teflon, PVC, synthetic rubber, etc., is following these. Most of the polymer reactions are following Ziegler-Natta catalyst, right friends? So that is why Ziegler and Natta, these are the two scientists, got Nobel Prize during 1963.